I don't care. Go to McDonald's. I have been up at 3 in the morning. We have been putting out. Right, we all were. What is that? We were here again putting out the fire. I am sorry. What is that?
Calm down.
You don't
storm up here.
No, excuse me. I've been up at 3, sir. I am your
roommate. I know you're roommate. Right. I've got it under control.
I don't care. This stuff, win this win. Are you guys nuts?
No, we're not. We're 5-6 in the standby
room. I don't care. That's an insult. We were up at
this
3 in the morning.
This is private property as well.
I don't care.
You've got no right to
I will be here. Happy. Well, you can come over and put the fire out at my house.
No problem.
Because we were right up there at 3 in the morning when your place went over in
there.
But you're gotta be nuts!
You can, thank you.
All right, no, I will call the police.
Fine, no problem.
Should have been called yesterday. No, that's ridiculous, people! Get real!
Welcome to the neighborhood.
This Karen's in South Africa. And where do we begin? Let's start with this mayor, this whole argument about, because her next ploy, I'll call the police, will be, I'm in fear, but you drove over there. You started screaming and berating this gentleman in another country in his face. And then it was so high, it was so pitchy, okay? And then you drove off with the threat. Mayor, is this Karenism so far out of hand that no matter where Karens are throughout the world, globally, they do feel that they're beyond reproach?
I mean, listen, let's not pretend that whiteness, because the ideal of Karen is this whiteness, right? It does not stop at geopolitical borders. We absolutely know that. And it's ironic that we're looking at one from South Africa, a place that has a unique relationship to Black Americans, in that while most of our enslaved ancestors did not come from that part of Africa, we know that we had segregation and they had apartheid, and the physiological effects on South Africans and Blacks is so close. So to see her screaming and ranting so loud because of what could have happened but didn't happen yesterday, and also her pulling out her AK-47, which is the police, is par for the course. I mean, and when I say that, I mean that. Karens use the police as their AK-47s.
Yeah, and I think that by coming over there and getting in his face, it was empowering for her. It was her way of saying, I'm still in charge, and no matter how big you are, I get to call the shots here. You know, there's this inner anger that I really want to know, Mayor, why they're so angry. You know, I have a theory that she probably was angry as barbecuing, as she's used to eating food with no seasoning, perhaps. Okay, she probably was angry at the food he was chefing up.
Yeah, I think like some of this anger is probably anger is a secondary emotion. I think it's related to something other than anger. It's this idea that I can control, I can do what I want to because of who I am.
Mm-hmm.
So this anger is, how dare you do something I wouldn't do in my presence? I have the right to check you because you did something I wouldn't do. Get in your car. That this is a fear. So if you truly were afraid, the first thing to do is call the police officers, not go scream in someone's face and escalate. You're in 3 or 4 people's face, pointing, screaming, then get back in your car and then says, I'm gonna call the police. Cause the call on the police now, you're already hyped up. So you're gonna call the police, you're gonna be crying. You're gonna act like your life was threatened and you could have died because of a fire that did not come across a hill yesterday, but you're mad because they barbecued and you wouldn't have barbecued, or you can't barbecue, and you didn't invite.
Yeah. If you really thought that there was an issue, if you really thought there was a threat, you would simply pick up the phone and say hi. You'd call the non-emergency number, quite frankly. You say, hi, I smell well-seasoned meat next door. I'm not sure if it's just a lovely family barbecue, or perhaps it could be something that could ignite, you know, some dry bushes nearby. Could you check it out, officer? Thank you. And then you go about your day. Didn't do that, Mayor.